Yeah.
It is the main role of parent. See,
main role of parent is because, see, life is beautiful, but life is also hard sometimes. Because the toughening process is required from the childhood. Ki ek opportunity gaya to dusra aata hai. God is always sending something. The only thing you should realize. Nokri gaya to theek hai, dusra bhi opportunity hai. Aisa nahi hai ki jindagi mein, and you have to, it is a role of the parent ki to show you ki tumhara ek pair gaya, some because of accident, there are people with surviving with, they don't have both hands and both legs also. Still they are blind people, you go outside, they are surviving alone, they are running some business or shop or whatsoever. I have seen in Dadar, once I was coming to Dadar station, I helped one blind people. He said, mujhe mat help karo, khali beech mein kuch hai to jara bata do karke. So, usko main station pe leke gaya. He said, last 7 years, he is going to Worli, he is running one shop, and he is, his age was 67. So, at this age, ghar mein bhi koi kamane wala nahi hai. So, he is surviving with a blind man. So, if थोड़ा बहुत इधर उधर हो गया तो immediately we are thinking for suicide and all this thing. Life has got lot of opportunities. एक opportunity गया तो दूसरा आता है. So this is the role of the main parents and friends. They should teach them to toughen. Like stress, it is very very easy to say I am stressed, I am depressed. But as per my knowledge, depression is a choice. See, leave apart clinical depression and all this thing, because now today it is the fashion that I am depressed and I am stressed. Depression you can remove by directed thinking. So if you, like you all know, ki as you think, you become. So if you are thinking positively, definitely you will see positive in other people and you will get opportunity. So it is the main role of parent to toughen the child. You know that child jab hi chalne ko sikhta hai, around 250 times he is falling and then again he is coming out. So you have to learn from child. The mainly is the toughening process. That's what I feel.
Yeah, I agree with you. Basically it is the support system around you which determines how well you are brought up and how much you can cope with what is happening to you. And well, it's society who develops that support system. I mean, it's already configured in your life. I mean, your support system is around you. You have parents, you have friends, you have relatives, you have a peer group. That is your support system. But basically, man is a social animal. I mean, you do need the support. Yeah. It is always necessary. You do need someone else's support. I mean, you need people around you. You can't live on your own. No. You do need to inculcate that ability to develop your own self, definitely. But you also need the support of others. I would. Sushmita,
I just want to answer your question. You said that you need to depend on yourself. That's a wonderful thing. That's a choice you make all the time. Whether you want to choose depending on yourself or take help from others, what Johnson is saying, if there is some help which is missing in your life, some support, you need to seek that support. Not be afraid to seek that support. If you can get the support yourself, within yourself, that's a wonderful thing. That's the best thing that can happen. But not all are strong and strong within to give yourself that support. Right, Vincent? Yeah, I'm glad. I think you want to share. You've been...
Like, share something?
Yeah, that's what, you know, the maturity levels differs from person to person. All may not be, you know, have that same maturity. And it depends on so many factors, like the way you have been brought up, your mental frame up, then whatever, like, how your personality is. Some people, I think, even we must have seen, like, people commit suicide even for trivial reasons, like failure in love, this affairs or whatever, marriage, you know, divorce. So, and would you like, I think we have so many, like, I don't know, but Hindus, at least among Hindus, we have got so many practices, you know, which can, if we start from early age, like Vipassana, or, you know, which makes you, I think, very strong, as a strong within, to look as like there are Sakshi Bhav. So you have to be, no, you have to, you can, no. Like, you know, we can always detach, we can always make it understand, you know, to ourselves, like, whatever is happening is not, it will always, even this too shall pass, and nothing stays, nothing is permanent, basically, in this world, not even our troubles, which is very important too, you know.
Absolutely, thank you.
Don't wait for things to pass, act on things and it will pass. This will also go away, try to act on your own.
Yeah, it's easier said than done. It's not that easy to act on things on your own. No, it's fine. What you're saying is right. But if you are in that frame of mind where you can do it, you won't think in terms of suicide. It's because you're not in that frame of mind that you start thinking of suicide.
Is it not we expect more than what we get? Like, you know, when the expectation goes behind, like, that time expectation is not fulfilled, that time we... The pressure comes in.
See, but where does the expectation come from? Does it come from within you or from outside you? Only from within you? Yeah. See, basically... The expectations are from outside because you are not born with expectations, are you? Are you born with expectations? No. So the expectation is basically coming from outside. The society is putting those expectations on you. Yeah? But when you're a child, you're not thinking in terms of facing expectations. It's how you develop yourself, right? Yeah. Everyone develops in a different way depending on the support system that they have in their lives. Definitely, if you have the willpower, you wouldn't be thinking in terms of suicide, you would just continue with life, you would be able to tackle everything that happens in your life.
That's not the major percentage of people, you know. That's not the major percentage of people who does everything alone. It's not possible.
It's not possible, yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Yeah, definitely, it does. But when I... See, I'll tell you, right now, families are in a transition phase in India today because urbanization, globalization, everything is happening at the same time and people are changing so fast that their bodies and minds can't cope with what is happening. Yeah, so that once that stabilizes, only then will support really work. Right now, it's not going to work because people are really pulled in so many different directions. Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. They have their own viewpoints. Yeah. Yeah.
Well, let me digress and touch upon a subject which is which can strike an emotional chord. I have had being a lawyer in the course of 14 months of advocacy, I had the opportunity to meet certain intelligence bureau, that is the intelligence agency of India and research analysis and wing, that is another intelligence agency. So I had one interaction with one of the intelligence, and I also know the chief investigating officer. You know, when you're a toddler, you're a child, your mind is impressionable as well as vulnerable. Now if you inculcate a belief system which gives you the strength to face life's challenges from a futuristic perspective. Now for instance, the terrorists who attacked, who perpetrated the havoc and the bloodbath and the mass murder 26-11, they were dressed in casual attire. Most of them were youngsters. School dropouts. Now, these school dropouts are indoctrinated. The term is indoctrination. Now, they're indoctrinated from the childhood to believe, look, you need to kill somebody who's a...